The PoE network is limited to about 328 feet. If the distance between the IP camera and the PoE switch is beyond 328 feet, the signal will start dropping. We can add this PoE standard to repeat the PoE network. One PoE standard can repeat another 328 feet. Usually, we need to place this PoE standard before 328 feet. If we have multiple run-run links, we need to place the PoE standard to each of these links. Instead, we also can use the long-run PoE switch. These two are long-range PoE switch. This is the 4-port version. Only half of the port support long-run. This is the 8-port version. Also, only half of the port support long-run. Now, let's test one of the switch. I'll choose the 4-port version. Before we move on to test everything, we need to get the long-run cable. This long-run PoE switch can supply maximum up to 1,600 feet. The first problem is I cannot get any cable beyond 1,000 feet. So I had to use this coupler. This coupler to chain another pool of cable. Eventually, we got 1,600 feet. This is nothing, just a waterproof coupler. It allowed me to join two cables together to get 1,600 feet. Okay, before we connect everything together, there's one thing I would like to emphasize. It's very important to choose the K5 or K6 cable, which is made of 100% copper. Because 100% copper can guarantee the power loss will be the minimum. The second thing is about the connector. If you don't have well-made RJ45 network connector, you may lose the signal. But we can always test everything, test the cable with the whole system before we put the cable in the field. If there's no way you can test the cable, you also can use the short punch cord to link the whole system up. If it's working, then the problem comes from the cable. Okay, now let me power up the switch. I need to use the short punch cord to link the one of the ports to the NVR. Now the NVR attached to this PoE switch. This is the long-run cable. Let me connect to the port number one, which is supplied the long-run. Let's move to the camera. From the camera, I also need to use this PoE adapter. You may wonder why we still need the PoE adapter. The PoE switch can supply long-run, but for this camera, it's just a regular camera. We need to use this PoE adapter to return the signal up to 1,600 feet. Let's connect the long-run cable to the input port of the PoE adapter and use this short punch cord to link the output port to the camera. Now let's check the indicator. You can see both indicators on, which means the IP camera is communicating with this long-run PoE switch. It will take a while before we can see the live video on the monitor. I think the camera's live now. This is motorized zoom camera. It will take a while to zoom in and zoom out to find the best focus. We just use single long-run up to 1,600 feet to supply the PoE from the switch to the camera. There's no need for power source at the camera end. It's pretty nice, right? There's one last thing. Can we also use this system to repeat the only data network, such as this router? The different thing is, this is the PoE camera. It needs both power and data. But this is just the router. It doesn't need the PoE. If we place this router to the end of the cable, it will not work because we still need to add this PoE splitter at the end of the cable. Why we need the PoE splitter? Before the PoE switch in the standard PoE system, before it releases the power to the edge, it needs to classify, verify edge device is also PoE compatible product. But this is non-PoE equipment. That's the reason why we need to have the PoE splitter to satisfy the power handshaking in the PoE system. Thanks for watching. See you next time.